Yeah. Real quick question. Mm-hmm. You're an expert as a business of boxing. Mm-hmm. As a business of boxing moved to Dallas, Texas, you had Floyd in Vegas for so long. Is Errol Spence calling the shots now?
In the welterweight division, he's Errol's the man that arguably everybody looks to now as the guy in the division. Tremendous fighter. He's complete. He does everything well. But you have a number of other good welterweight fighters out there, and whether it be Porter, Thurman, Pacquiao, Crawford, all the top welterweights out there. The welterweight division, I think, is the hottest division in the entire sport.
How would you move him? Obviously, people would consider you a maestro, expert at moving welterweight, even moving fighters. How would you move him going forward?
Danny?
No.
Earl? Earl's looking to fight the biggest fights that are out there. In the past, it seemed like that some of the fighters have, it has appeared that they've been reluctant to fight him. In some cases, it's been true. And in other cases, there's miscommunication. I think that Danny Garcia is one that I think he eagerly would like to fight a Spence. But again, he has to get through Adrian Granados, again, who's a tough, tough, hard-nosed fighter. He's a high-volume puncher, his style. He's going to force you to fight. Danny has a great counter-punching style, but also Danny's a very good boxer. You know, him and his dad, I'm sure they've made some adjustments. And you make adjustments depending upon the fighters that you fight on that particular night. Danny's a terrific fighter. He knows how to win. He's a winner. Yeah, he's a winner. And he's a winner at 147, too. He just come up on the short end of the stick in two debatable decisions. I'm not saying that it should have went this way or that way. Again, I was at both fights. Both guys laid it on the line, and he just happened to come up on the short end of the stick. As the same in Adrian Granado's case, but it just hadn't been those type of fighters. And, you know, so that's what I think. Both guys are hungry. In the past, Danny's been criticized for fighting down to the level of its competition or whatever. But Danny sees it was at a stake, and I think he wants to go out and make a big statement and show the world again why he's one of the best welterweights out there in the world.
What rematch would you see in your